someone says hi doesn't actually mean they're your friend.
Say hi, everyone.
Hey guys, good morning. I hope you guys are doing really, really well. Oh my god, I don't even remember the last time I've done a video like this. It feels like decades, honest to god. Oh my. But yeah, I will be taking you guys with me in a weekend vlog. It is currently Friday morning. Santi has just left to nursery. I've got little Chica here. She's having a bit of tummy time on the floor. Not really enjoying it, but she soon should be going down for a nap. So I'm just letting her tire herself out. But yeah, everything has been going quite okay. I don't really know what I'm doing today. I don't know if I'm going to go to my mom's. I don't know if I'm not. Like, I don't know. I just feel so exhausted. Like, I haven't had energy to do anything. I was even mentioning this to Ivan yesterday. I was like, I just don't know what's wrong with me. My energy is just not there. It really sucks because I hate feeling this way. But I just don't know why I feel this way. Last evening was... Santi was really, I don't know if it's because his routine was all over the place, because I took him swimming in the morning, which it's normally not, it's normally on a Sunday, and then he went to nursery because I needed him to go because I had to get some things done. If not, I would have kept him. Then my in-laws went to pick him up, and then he came home. He was super exhausted, he was super tired, but I think he was angry at me at the same time because I dropped him off, and he was really upset when I dropped him off. So I don't know, he was just, oh no, he was just, he didn't eat anything, he was refusing everything, gave him a bath, he was then like flipping his legs everywhere while I was dressed. It was just a nightmare, let's just put it that way. It was not nice. I actually had a little breakdown to myself yesterday. It was so sweet because I had it while I was dressing him. I just started to cry because I was like trying to like keep my patience, and when keeping my patience in like that, I just cry. That's just how I am. And he was just like cuddling me and really worried about me, and I felt really bad doing that in front of him. But sometimes you just can't help it, and instead of shouting at him or losing myself, I just literally burst into tears. So it was hard because I always get the worst out of him in the evenings. Obviously in the morning he's really lovely, but I only get to leave him for like 10 minutes before my father-in-law comes and takes him to nursery. Then at nursery he probably has a good time, I'm not too sure, but I'm sure he does. And then like he sleeps, and then my in-laws get like the nice side of him, and then I get the hell. So it's really sad, but it's Friday today, that means tomorrow is Saturday. I'm not really sure what I'm gonna do, because every time I go to my mom just wants them to sleep over. So, and I feel really bad leaving them there. So I don't know, but yeah, I do want to go see my dad and stuff, because I had literally not seen him the whole week. So I do want to go see my sister, chat with my sister for a bit. Really need a good sister chat. And then, yeah, I don't know what else. Sunday, obviously, I've got swimming. That's pretty much. Oh, actually, I have my uncle's 50th and my other uncle's birthday tomorrow at my godmother's house. Let me go and get the girl because she's getting upset.
So yeah, say hi everybody. So yeah, so tomorrow we have a birthday party, and then Sunday we pretty much don't have anything. So I'm gonna take you guys with me. So we're gonna take you with mama. She's been doing so well. Like, I'm so proud of her. Like, since we've changed cot, she has been sleeping all night. I mean, this night she woke up, but bless her, she had a poo. So yeah, I mean, I'm not expecting her to sleep all night anyway. So Tiago went until I think he was nearly 9 months, if I'm not mistaken, where he would wake up at least once for a feed. But I did start realizing that his feed was just a habit, so I slowly started to cut that off, and it worked. With her, I don't really think she's that hungry. Even yesterday, she was struggling to fall asleep. I was like, maybe she's hungry because it's been like nearly 7 hours since she had an air. So I was like, let me go and do her like a 5 ounce bottle. I'd done it, but she was eating, but she was like not enjoying it. So I just think that she had it for having, but I don't really think she really needed it. So I don't know. She's always been like that though. She hasn't been, never been much of an amazing night drinker. Even in Spain, when she was going through a sleep regression, I was doing her a bottle, but she wasn't really enjoying it, if that makes sense. Like, you know when your baby's really enjoying that milk, and she just didn't seem like she was enjoying it at all. So yeah, she's got two teeth. See, I've got two teeth, yay! She's got two teeth, so I am gonna really start like weaning her now. I have been giving her like little puree. I gave her a little like I gave her mashy banana in Spain, just like mashed with my own hand. And then I gave her a little puree pouch here, but she didn't really enjoy it much. So I think she's going to be a bit like Santi. Santi did it. He enjoyed them, but he really preferred when I gave him the real thing. So yeah, the only reason why I actually do purees is because my mother-in-law is literally freaked out giving them anything that's not a puree. And obviously I'm going back to work, and obviously that's what she's going to be giving us. So I don't want to get her used to too much, like, easy stuff, like eating actual food, and then when she has the puree she's gonna be like, whoa. So we're doing an in between. I've done it the same with Santi and it worked fine. He liked it, some stuff he didn't, which is fine. I'm gonna do the same with her. I'm not expecting like everyone to feel comfortable doing this, and obviously my mother-in-law is helping me by staying with them from 2 o'clock. So obviously putting her in that position to make her uncomfortable or something happening and her feeling bad, I just don't want to put her in that position. So yeah, I'm not expecting her to do that. I'm very thankful that she stays with them anyway. So I couldn't put her in that position. Her or my father-in-law, because I know he doesn't like it either.
I'm gonna go and see grandma and granddad. Yeah? And get spoiled. Yeah?
So yeah, that's basically it. So I'm gonna take you guys with me today. Hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. Take you guys with me for the whole week. So yeah, let's do this.
I put Letty to sleep. I didn't film all of that because I realized my battery was a bit low. I put Letty to sleep and I had a bath, which felt amazing. And now I'm getting skincare ready. You might put it on wake up today. It's Friday, why not? But yeah, I really want to come and talk to you guys about a little thing. For those who have been following me for ages would know that since I've had babies, or since I've had Santi, I've always wanted to do their christening, obviously out in Spain. But unfortunately, due to realizing that what happened to my dad this year in Portugal, the hassle we had to send him over there, and we just don't think he's going to be able, like, he needs to always go with a certificate to travel now, fit to fly. If he doesn't have that, they won't let him go on the plane because he needs oxygen on the plane and he has to use a little machine thingy, and that machine can't go without saying that he's fit to fly, basically. So it doesn't look like, I mean, I don't know, but you know, we're not expecting like great miracle recoveries. So because of that reason, me and Evan have decided that we're doing their christenings here. It's super important for me for my dad to be present. Obviously, me and Evan are very family orientated people, so it's really important for our families to be around us and to, you know, just to have the people we love around us. In Spain, they don't really do big christenings. So in Spain, it's literally your like intimate family. So it's like house family, like brothers, sisters. They don't invite like aunties and uncles, really and truly. But obviously, because in Portugal we do, I said to Eamon, like, I'm sticking to that tradition. Like, we stuck to some traditions, yours, the Spanish ones, for the wedding. So like, my tradition is to invite like my family and friends. So that's what we're doing. So it is going to be quite a big, well, we are going to invite everyone, all our family and friends. We're being very cautious on friends. We're not inviting people that just, there's people that don't even know Letty. Do you know what I'm saying? There's people that don't even know Santi. Like, they won't even know what Santi's favorite anything is. They won't even know, you know, anything about Santiago. So it's just because someone says hi doesn't actually mean they're your friend. And I've learned this in a very hard way. So we're being very cautious on that. We are getting to, like, I think I'm gonna give ourselves a deadline. So we're gonna get to like, because obviously we need to, because Santi has his godfather in Spain and Letty has both in Portugal and Spain. None of them are here. So obviously we need to let them know quite early, you know, when it's gonna be, what day, da 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 da. So we're gonna give ourselves at least until November to have our final list, have our invitations done, and that's it. We're not going back and forth. That's it. Whoever's invited then is, who isn't coming, and that's it. So, I mean, obviously they can give us time to tell us when they come in. I mean, like, us giving the invitations. So yeah, we're doing it here. Oh my God, is it hard to get things done here? Like, I thought it would have been quite easy, but it's actually really difficult. So I found a videographer. if anyone has any other suggestions, please let me know in the comments below. I have found a videographer, we found a photographer, fingers crossed. We're gonna actually have to meet with him and speak about a few things, but the videographer I think I found, venue hopefully I think also we found and it's just a church now. But yeah, it's been quite hectic. It hasn't really been easy. I don't want to stress with nothing on that day, so I'm not doing my own decorations. I don't want to do none of that. Maybe the only thing me and my sister might do is the favors, because I feel like favors you can do at any time throughout the year. But I just feel like I can't stress the decorations the day before. I can't do that. I just want it to be a very nice, smooth, things get done for me. I just go to the place and that's it. Obviously the kids are probably most definitely getting dressed here in my house and our house, and then I think I'm gonna have like a little like buffet, like food and drink in the garden. We're not sure when we're doing it. We're definitely doing it next year summer, but the date hasn't been confirmed, so we don't know. But yeah, just to let you guys know that the christening and the baptism, I don't know, are going to be done here. In a way it's good because I'm here and I can sort it out. When it's out there, I saw my wedding, it's quite stressful. So that's a good thing about it when it's here, is that you're here and you can deal with it here. But yeah, I think that's really it. And I will be taking you guys along with me. You know how I am, I love it. I've done it on my wedding and I'm definitely going to do it again. I think it's amazing. I'm going to turn this light on my thingy off. It's just too much in my face. Because I've got a light on the camera and I just feel like it's just getting too much. But yeah, the same way I took you guys along with me in my wedding, I'm going to do the same. Any good suggestions of hairdressers that are like mobile, because I would really prefer they come to us. I really can't be bothered to go to a salon on the day, especially around my area. Do you know how expensive it is around here? So if you guys know of anyone that actually travels and will come to me, that would be like a lifesaver. That would be great. But yeah, just there's a lot of things to sort out, but I'll be bringing you guys with me. It's not like my wedding, I don't have 2 years to plan, have a year, so things need to get done because time goes.
Sorry about that whole interruption, my memory card has lost space. I've got so much rubbish on this memory card, I actually need to go on and literally delete a lot of stuff. But I did delete some old videos, so hopefully I've got enough space right now. For now. But a lot of has happened since that, like me getting ready. Letty had woken up, then obviously I had to be with her, play with her for a bit and stuff like that. And what else? Nothing much now. I don't know what's going on with her. I think she's going for another little growth moment because she's ate earlier than she had to, and she wants to go to sleep earlier than she normally goes to. So I don't know what really is going on, but maybe she's just going for a growth little moment. Or maybe it is the fact that she needs to actually start eating solids. Maybe the milk is just not giving her enough. Because that did kind of happen with Santi. So maybe it's the same thing with her. Look at how much clothes this girl has, like honestly. But she's still not fully asleep. But I've left her in the bed and she normally self-soothes. So hopefully she will. And I can just get other bits done. I need to hoover the house and stuff like that. So that's what I'm going to be doing. But yeah, sorry for that little interruption. It wasn't meant to happen, but things happen, guys, and you just have to roll. Guys can see me properly, hopefully you can. Literally just ordered myself some MACD's. I could not be bothered to even think about cooking or anything, so I was like, I'm just gonna order myself. I haven't ate McDonald's in bloody ages, to be fair. How cool are these like new little like scrapey things? Look, how cool are these? I think they were really here for when I was at home. That's so cool, isn't it? That's so wicked. Wow. This fucking like drinks spilled everywhere. Honestly, this driver was in the same spot for like half an hour. I don't know what the hell he was doing. And now I get here, my drinks all spilled. Now my straw is soaked. Damn paper straws. Happy Friday, guys. Happy Friday. Yeah, anyways, I'm gonna eat and enjoy this as much as I can because I feel it's gonna be cold anyway. But yeah, let you sleep in.
It's about 12:10 right now. And I'm going to eat and enjoy it and watch some TV. And yeah, after this, probably get Santi at 2 o'clock. Hopefully she wake up by the time we go. Oh God, I literally forgot about that. Pick him up and I head to my mom's. Grandma
Bye, babe. Hey guys, good morning. Let me turn this way because the lighting is much better. Right. Good morning, gorgeous people. It is now Saturday morning. Sorry, yesterday I actually didn't feel much. So from when I went to my mum, I didn't film anything. I was like, I'm gonna film, and then I completely forgot. So all I really did was be with my mum. Then went to pick up my sister from work. When we dropped my sister off, I went straight shopping with my mum to get some stuff for the house. And then we came back home, we had dinner, we sorted out the kids. I put the kids in bed because they stayed at my mum's because we have a party today. And I have to go that way anyway. So my mum was like, just let them sleep here, let them relax. Because I did stay at my mum's nearly until 12 at night because we just chatted, me, my mum and my sister. A lot about the christening, like we're chatting about the baptism of the children, like what we're going to do and things like that. Like, you know, we could think it's a whole year, but it is next year and the time does fly. Like soon it's just going to be Christmas talk. I want Letty to have one of the best first Christmases like Santi did. Hopefully we will do it here. I really want to do it in our house this year. So funny to see the two high chairs there. God, how time flies. So I really want to do it. I would love to do it here, but obviously we normally do it with like all my family. My family's quite big, so I don't know. And obviously with my dad as well. And I don't know how it would be with like how hot we would get here. I mean, we can open our windows. That's not a problem. But yeah, I don't know if that's going to work. I mean, my dad's got my room. You can always chill and sleep there and relax there if he wants. But we see because of his oxygen and stuff, we don't really know if that's going to really work. But yeah, anyway, moving forward. So yeah, soon it's going to be all that talk, Halloween talk. I want to go to the pumpkin fields again as well. I think this year Santi would love it because he can actually experience it. So we want to do all of that. So soon the conversation of that is not even going to happen. So yeah. Ooh, my mom was such a sweetheart. And she ironed me so many clothes. They're all there. I need to put that away. I'm going to change our beds. I'm going to change the kids' beds. I don't even know if I can change the kids' beds. I don't think I ironed their sheets. And I've got this thing about their sheets not being ironed. So I probably will have to iron those like today or tomorrow and then swap it for Monday. I mean, I did change them during the week, so this shouldn't be that bad. But when I change one, I like change all of them. I'm a weirdo. I'm going to do that, probably hoover the house quickly. I have my eyebrows at 12:45. I'm going to get them done because these need sorting. Look at that. Real sorting. Haven't done them, guys. Be proud of me. I literally haven't done them since before summer. That's mad. That's been like nearly 9 weeks. I've been like plucking like little ones out myself, but now they really need to do. So I'm going to go and get that done. And then I think that's it, really. That's not right. And then go to the party. We are trying to find a way to get rid of this sofa because we do have our new sofa coming tomorrow. I'm hoping it's a good sofa. I really found this sofa so uncomfortable.
Like, I just don't find it cozy at all. And now that winter's coming, I just want something really cozy and nice. So we bought another one and I want to get rid of this one. It's going to my godmother's house. But we're trying to find a way to take it all the way to South London. Like, all the zip vans around here are like fully booked for the whole weekend. So we don't really have a way to take it. So hopefully we do find a way. And then, yeah, and then that's it for today. There's not really much to do. It's so weird to be at home. And in this, I can hear the birds outside. Can you guys hear them? Like, as a mom of two, that's unbelievable that I can hear the wind. I can hear all these stuff. Like, it's just so weird. Normally the house is like, So yeah, I need to get those done. Oh, if you guys know of a nice place where I can get a really good diary, like diary/notebook, because I need to get one for work now, please shout a go up. I really, really need to find one, a really good one. I got to sleep until 9. I know that's not much for some people, but for someone who wakes up at 6:30 every morning, waking up at 9 was really good. Like, even woke up, got ready, because he had to go somewhere with his parents. I managed to sleep throughout that. Round of applause to me. I'm so proud of myself. So proud. But yeah, I'm so grateful for my mom and my sister when they get to keep the kids. Honestly, like, guys, if you guys have the help and if someone is offering the help, accept it. Let it go. Accept it, guys. You guys don't understand how refreshed I get just for that night of sleep, because then tomorrow I have Santi swimming and stuff, so I'm back up early, I'm back like doing my stuff. But it's so nice to get that sleep in. It's so nice to be able to get things done and not having the kids running around everywhere. My brain works so much better when the house is all sorted and clean, and for my mental health, I need it done. So yeah, if someone's offering to help, take it. Okay, take it. I know it's really hard. I know the mom guilt plays straight away, but take it. Honestly, you're gonna feel 20,000 times better. Believe me, okay? But yeah, so I'm gonna head off. There's not really much to have breakfast. Really, we need to go shopping. There's some cereal, so I might have some cereal. I don't really know what I want, to be fair. I don't know, I'm just here. I wish the sofa was just a little bit more comfy, because I probably would have fell asleep again. But yeah, this talk is going on for way too long. So yeah, see you guys soon. Peace out. I love how our new car has an amazing space to put my camera on when I want to like chat like this with you guys. I'm on my way to go and do my eyebrows. Don't you guys just hate receiving letters? I used to always hated it. I mean, I come from a back history with my family that, oh my god, I need to put aircon or something, it's hot in there. Like, where our letters are never good news. They were always terrible news, my dad's health or whatever. So I get petrified. Like, it's actually a trauma for me when I get letters, and then when I see Santi's name on one of them, oh god, I'm like, my heart's like dun. But we're actually, I don't know if you guys follow me or not, I'm not sure if you guys have been, well, how long you've been following me. If you haven't, make sure you do. Santi, since a while last year, we had noticed that his breathing when he sleeps is really funny. His breathing, he's always has this like cough, and obviously in my family, one of my cousins used to be really like that. So when he sleeps, he's very like he's always snotty, but he's not. So I have an experience in my family. One of my cousins actually had to get her tonsils removed because they were too big for like the size of her throat and stuff like that. So obviously I went to the doctors, I was really on top of them, and we went to see them around June. They gave us a course of antibiotics for 3 months to see if it was just like sort of, because they say that sometimes you can gain like a slight infection in your, like, I forgot what it's called, it was ages ago. But yeah, I've put all of that in like my TikTok if you guys want to go over there and see it. And they gave us an appointment literally the day we got here of the journey, and I was like, there is no way I'll be able to go
go that day. I'm exhausted and we go by car, we do a long journey. So they sent us another one for the end of this month. So I really want to stay on top of them because I really want to see, even if he does have like his tonsils quite big, they won't operate him until he's older anyway, but I still want to be on top of it and make sure that, you know, if that's the issue, because I feel like Letty's getting the same issue. So yeah, I'm going to be on top of them. But anyways, I'm off to do my eyebrows now and I'm going to take you guys with me, why not. But yeah,
so close. Maud, say hello. Say hello to everyone. Say hello, everyone. This is Santi.
They've got their fried eating macaron.
Yeah.
Anything you have to eat.
I love you, princessa. Hi, Nina.
Oh. She's like, this is what my dad plays. So this is what my dad plays. Chris, look at him. Look at him, Chris. Look what he's doing. Look what he's doing. Look. Yeah, you have to wipe the floor.
No,
is it more now? Santi, is enough now. Guys, happy Sunday. Hey, Bula, say happy Sunday. So it's Sunday today. Yesterday we got home quite late. I think I ended up falling asleep by like 1:45. They were superstars. They literally just went to bed and fell asleep. Letty's actually still sleeping because she did wake up to her little bottle. Well, she had a poo at 5:30, and anytime Letty has a poo, whatever she's at an hour before or 2 hours, she empties her stomach, she gets hungry. So I gave her like a 6 ounce bottle and then she fell asleep, but she's still sleeping right now. So yeah, I'm just here with Santi right now. My sitting room, as you guys can see, is empty. No sofa, no table. We're getting a new sofa today. So Ivan has went to take the sofa to my godmother's house because she wants to keep our one. And he took that, so we literally have nothing. That nothing except a little mat with some toys for them. So it's been quite boring at the moment. But he's just had his milk,
isn't it, Santi?
He's just had his milk, and I was playing with some balls, obviously. And soon I'll probably have to give him breakfast because we do have his swimming today. Which is at 1:00. It's a horrible time, to be fair. I don't really like that time, but it's the time that we've got. So it's at 1:00 and he has to eat an hour and a half before. So I don't normally give him anything too heavy. I just like give him breakfast and then I just give him proper food when he leaves and he gets home. I just give him a snack as well because he gets very hungry. But I don't like giving him too much food because I'm scared he's gonna vomit. So that's basically it. Ivan's gonna go football today.
What?
Did he take your ruler?
Oh dear, Flash. So yeah, I'm going to try and have some breakfast myself as well. But yeah, just bringing you guys along. There hasn't been much happening in this world apart from me talking, but I'm getting the hang of it. Still, I'm trying to get the hang of always using my camera. I keep forgetting it in the car and stuff like that. It's just, ugh, it's really annoying. But yes, guys, that's what's happening today.
Let's go to Mena. Let's go to Mena. Let's go. Say Letty.
Bless her.
Hello, gorgeous girl. Hi, beautiful girl. Hi, gorgeous. Hello, my beautiful. Are you ready to wake up? Yeah? Oh, hello, beautiful.
Let's turn your noise machine off.
Yeah. You're my gorgeous. Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
So, two little musketeers there. I'm giving Letty, don't mind the bowl, I still need to buy her some cutlery. We've got some, like, porridge. It's not porridge, it's baby rice, I think it's called. Trying to see if she likes, trying to introduce that to her this week, because nursery is close approaching. Isn't it, Princessa? And little Mist over here is having some Cocoa Pops, is having a little treat today on a Sunday. Bless him, he doesn't get any stuff during the week because he's at nursery. Isn't it? Enjoying it? Yeah? So yeah, that's what he's doing, and I'm feeding this little munchkin right here.
Is there a boiler in there? Ooh.
Where's the crocodile? Where's the crocodile?
Another one, thank you. Another one, thank you. Otra, obrigada. Obrigado. Tantas bolas!
Letty! Do you want this one? I'll give this one to Mana.
She has that one now.
Can we give that one to my mouth? Hold it. Thank you. Thank you. And a crocodile.
Snap, 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 snap.
Thank you. Don't want me to
see you. So, Sophie's arrived, and Ethan's just gone to football, but he will be building that once he gets back. I don't really know if we're going to see each other. No, we won't see each other because I will be heading to swimming. Letty is sleeping. Sandy's having a nap as well. He really needed it. He was just so tired. He normally doesn't ever have like morning naps, but he just needed one today. Yesterday we had like a long day. I don't know, it's very different when he's at home than to like when he's at nursery. Like he always has that extra little nap. I don't know why. But anyway,
yeah, they're both sleeping, and I've just been doing like bits and bobs, like washing and stuff like that. But it's been like a very tiring morning. I don't know why, but I just feel so exhausted. I think that's really it. Oh yeah, and then my mother-in-law is going to come stay with Letty while I go swimming with Santi, and then Eamon will be coming. He'll be kind of arriving by the time I leave, but he should be getting there by like 1 o'clock. So yeah, then I'll be going there, and then he'll be starting the sofa, so hopefully it's more comfy. It's bigger, it's more comfy, hopefully. I just can't wait. I just can't wait. I'm just hoping it's not huge and humongous for the sitting room. But yeah, I don't want to think about that too much. We also got rid of the table finally. Oh god, that table's getting on my nerves. But yeah, guys, I was just giving you guys a quick update. I can't chill because I don't have the sofa, so I don't really know what to do. So it's been a while since the day. I've gone swimming, I've come back, and the sofa's up. Oh my god, it's so much nicer than the one we had. It's similar colour, but so much nicer. Let me show you guys properly. Ooh. Look at it. 10,000 times better. I can't even explain it. Took a few hours to put it together, but all done. The both kids are napping, sleeping-ish, which is good. And yeah, just realized I think even put the wrong cushion. That cushion is, anyway, I'll do that in a second. But yeah, that's basically all that's happening. I need to sort out my sitting room because it looks a disaster. Oh, that's also the footrest thing. Super excited. So I'm gonna do that, and then I also have to start making dinner because I haven't had a proper lunch or breakfast today. So I need to have a really good dinner.
Shay Daddy's hand. Thank you.
Charles, so afraid that you wouldn't come in time. The boat's arrived. It's the boat that's come to take us home to England.
Is it nice?
I was wondering. Well, we really hope.
Santi, what do you have to eat? Albert.
Hey guys, good morning. It's actually Monday morning. I didn't get to film last night the end to this vlog because I just really needed to chill. I was super tired. Yvonne was exhausted as well. We just got in our new sofa, so we were really just embracing the new sofa and having fun. Little Missy's over here. Say hi. Say hi, everyone. Hi, good girl. So yeah, and I'm just gonna close up this video. I know it wasn't much, nothing much happened, but I just feel like I need to get back into the, you know, zone of me filming. And I thought, like, let me start this weekend. I just keep forgetting the camera and stuff, and like my car and things like that, and I just don't get to film a lot because so much happens, but oh, I just forget to film. It's really annoying. But yeah guys, I really hope you guys enjoyed that and coming along with me on that vlog. I'm definitely gonna have some more coming out. I do plan on doing a little, whoever's been following me for a while, you remember that I used to have the chit and the chat. That's definitely coming back with different people, but definitely coming back. I'm just trying to think of like a different sort of thing to do during on the video. I don't know, sometimes we might be eating, sometimes drinking, I'm not too sure, but I'm just trying to change it up a little bit, and obviously arranging the time with people to actually do it, because it is very hard to find the time to actually film because people have their own lives, people work and stuff, so it's tricky. But yeah, stay tuned, make sure you subscribe if you haven't already, and follow my crazy ass journey. But yeah guys, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.